still get nightmares about that ratta maroing you had to do in school? Why are Indians so obsessed with rote learning anyway?
Understanding, enrichment, enhancement and education of the human brain through sensory route of vision, sometimes touch.
अरे कहना क्या चाहते हो?
Some of the oldest educational institutions in the world, like Nalanda and Takshila, were located in the Indian subcontinent. There, debate and discussion between teachers and pupils was at the core of learning. But by the time British traders invaded India in the 17th century, these institutions had all but disappeared, and native education was limited to schooling the elite at gurukuls and madrasas. Though access at these institutions was limited, teaching methods focused on practical knowledge. For a long time, the British chose to support native learning, and many Orientalist scholars even encouraged the growth of indigenous and local institutions and texts. But in the 19th century, under the influence of Anglicist officers, English education was introduced in India in order to school the native Indians in the morally superior texts and culture of the West. And this is where rote learning enters the picture. Though the aim was to improve learning, English education, especially when the policy shifted towards mass education, ended up encouraging rote learning or memorizing and copying texts rather than enabling actual understanding, because they were far removed from the indigenous knowledge and everyday lives of students. By the mid-19th century, this kind of English education and the ability to memorize and restate information became the main criterion for getting jobs in the colonial administration. As this was the first time that jobs in the colonial government were made available to Indians, they quickly became the ultimate marker of success and respectability, especially for the Indian middle class. Unfortunately, this emphasis on rote learning remained strong in Indian education even post-independence. Evaluation methods in schools and colleges focused on rote learning instead of holistic development. A study comparing board exams across the globe found that rote learning was the highest in India and Pakistan. Another study showed that less than 5% of engineers educated in India have the analytical skills necessary for software engineering jobs. But if rote learning doesn't enable our students to learn the right skills, then why do we continue to emphasize it? Our abysmal spending and lack of focus on education has meant that India has one of the lowest teacher-student ratios in the world. When a single teacher is meant to teach classrooms of an average of 30 to 50 students, rote learning becomes an easy fallback because it ensures children can pass standardized tests even if they don't understand how to problem solve. Policy changes within education are trying to address these problems to move away from rote learning and focus on holistic development. But that will have little effect until we change our societal mindset, which equates success with test results.
Thoda aur pad leti to medical clear ho jata tera. Apne roommate ko dekh.
We care little about what children are actually learning and more about whether they are scoring more than Sharma ji ke bacche. And this mindset follows us into adulthood and impacts how we view our self-worth and measure success. And so challenging India's obsession with rote learning isn't just about changing an educational policy. It is about questioning and moving past this thinking which equates a human being's worth and potential to how well they score on a superficial result. That's it for the latest video in the Overthinking It series. If you enjoy overthinking with us, please don't forget to like, share, subscribe to the Swaddle, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you stay updated.